Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, which is Real Homeopathy. Do like, share and subscribe to my channel, and for more updates stay tuned and press the bell icon given below. So today in this class I'll be explaining on infertility. So what are its causes and what are the causes for male and what are the causes for female? We will be speaking it in this section, so stay tuned and watch till the end.
Of infertility, as we see. So firstly, we need to understand what is infertility. The definition of infertility, if we understand that, then we will understand what are the causes for male and then the causes for the female here. So definition, which is infertility, is defined as a failure to conceive within one or more years of regular unprotected coitus, which is a sex. So even after, why there is a no conceiving, which is to failure to conceive within one or more years of regular unprotected coitus. So two types of infertility, namely primary and secondary infertility. So primary infertility means it is those patients who have never conceived. Nextly, secondary infertility means it indicates previous pregnancy was there, but secondly, there is a inability to conceive for the second or the third time. So this is secondary infertility. Next, coming to fecundability. What is fecundability? Fecundability is defined as the probability of achieving a pregnancy within one menstrual cycle. In a healthy young couple, it is 20%. Fecundity is the probability of achieving a live birth within a single cycle. This is a fecundability and fecundity. Next, the incidence. What is the incidence now? Factors essential for conception. Healthy spermatozoa is the first contribution that has to be there. The factor considering here is this. It should be deposited high in the vagina at or near the cervix. The spermatozoa should undergo changes, which is capacitization, acrosome reaction, and acquire the motility, which is the cervical factor. The spermatozoa should undergo changes. There are certain changes that it has to undergo, and then it will acquire the motility. So this all comes under the cervical factor. The mobile spermatozoa should ascend through the cervix into the uterine cavity and the fallopian tube. So the spermatozoa should be motile. The movement of the spermatozoa should be there, and it should ascend through the cervix into the uterine cavity and to the fallopian tubes here. So these are the factors which are essential, and also there should be ovulation. Without any ovulation in females, it is very difficult to attain to conceive. It is very difficult. So that will come under the ovarian factor. The fallopian tubes, coming to the tubal factor, the fallopian tubes should be patterned and located, and that should be located, should be picked up by the fimbricated end of the tube. It should be picked up by the fimbricated end of the tube. That is contributing to the tubal factor. Next, the spermatozoa should fertilize the oocyte at the ampulla of the tube. It should fertilize the spermatozoa, the egg, the sperm and the egg should fertilize at the ampulla of the tube. Then only it will be able to conceive. And the second contribution will be the embryo should reach the uterine cavity after 3 to 4 days of fertilization. After 3 to 4 days of fertilization, the embryo should reach the uterine cavity. The endometrium should be receptive. The endometrium, what is there in the uterus, should be very receptive. So it should be able to receive the embryo attached to this endometrium. So by estrogen, progesterone, IGF-1 integrins for implantation. For implantation on the endometrium, this embryo should be capable of endometrium should be capable of implanting, and the corpus luteum should function adequately for the hormonal requirement. Next, coming to the physiological consideration here, conception is not possible during pregnancy as the pituitary gonadal axis is suppressed by this HCG, and hence there is no ovulation. So conception is not possible during pregnancy. Okay, this is the physiological consideration for infertility. Next, coming to the causes of infertility, conception depends on fertility potential of both the male and the female partner. Conception depends both. The male is responsible about 30-40%, the female is responsible about 40-55%, and both are equally responsible in 10% of cases. Next, coming to the faults in the male. So what are the faults that to be considered in the male? Is a defective spermatogenesis, obstruction in the efferent duct system, failure to deposit sperm high in the vagina, okay, errors in this fluid, seminal fluid. Next, what is defective spermatogenesis? Now, FSH stimulates spermatogenesis from basal cells of the seminiferous tubules. There are certain Sertoli cells which envelop the germ cells and support spermatogenesis here. Sertoli cell function is controlled by follicle stimulating hormone and the testosterone. There is also scrotal temperature which should be 1 to 2 degree Fahrenheit lesser than the body temperature. Luteinizing hormone is required for the synthesis of testosterone from the Leydig cells. So there is a defective spermatogenesis. In that you will see a sperm follicle stimulating hormone, which is a hormone deficiency, and also there is a scrotal temperature, and also there is a luteinizing hormone like follicle stimulating hormone, testosterone, luteinizing hormone. All of these factors are also considerable here. Follicle stimulating hormone also stimulates the Sertoli cells to produce androgen binding proteins and inhibit B. Androgen binding proteins binds to this testosterone hormone and dihydrotestosterone to maintain the high low concentration of the androgens. Even equally, androgens are responsible to conceive here. Spermatogenesis and sperm maturation need a high environment. So even the spermatogenesis and the sperm maturation need a high androgenic moment here. Approximately 74 days are required to complete the process of a spermatogenesis here. Approximately 74 days is essential. Next, causes of male infertility. So we'll see the important causes of male infertility are hypothalamic pituitary disorders, pituitary gonadal disorders, disorders of sperm transport, and idiopathic cause in the males. So first you'll see congenital causes here. Undescended testes is a congenital cause. The hormone secretion remains unaffected here, but the spermatogenesis is depressed. Vas deferens is absent in about 1-2% of males. Then Kartner syndrome, which is an autosomal disease. There is a loss of ciliary function and sperm motility. There is also loss of that, which is autosomal disease. There is a congenital cause. Hypospadias means causes to failure sperm high in the vagina. Next, coming to the thermal factor. First one was congenital cause. In that, for thermal factor, the scrotal temperature should be 1-2 degree Fahrenheit, the lesser than the body temperature, and it is raised conditions such as a varicocele. Varicocele probably interferes with the coiling mechanism or increases the catecholamine concentration here. Next, the third point is the infection, mump or chitin. is after puberty may permanently damage spermatogenesis in males. The quality of sperm is adversely affected by chronic systemic illness like bronchitis. Also respiratory infections like this thing can infect the or can damage the spermatogenesis in males. It will directly or indirectly cause difficulty to conceive here in males. The T. mycoplasma and or Chlamydia trachomatis infection is also implicated. Next, there is a general factors. General factors like chronic debilitating factors, also there is a chronic smoking, malnutrition reduces spermatogenesis. Alcohol inhibits spermatogenesis either by suppressing the Leydig cells synthesis of testosterone or possibly by suppressing these gonadotropin levels. There is chronic debilitating illness or alcohol, malnutrition and smoking will contribute to not conceive here and will contribute indirectly or directly to infertility in males. Next, coming to endocrine factors like testicular failure die to gonadotropin deficiency is rare. So follicle stimulating hormone level is raised in idiopathic testicular failure with germ cell actinemia is associated with this impotence. There is a genetic cause. Genetic like common chromosomal abnormality in zoocytes, which is male, is Klippel syndrome. Gene deletion has been detected in the long arm of Y chromosome for patients with severe oligospermia and a zoospermia here in genetic cause. Next, iatrogenic cause. Iatrogenic means radiation, cytotoxic drugs, nitrofurnation, cimetidine, beta blockers, antihypertensive, anticonvulsant, antidepressant drugs are likely to hinder the spermatogenesis. Next, coming to immunological factor, antibodies against spermatogenic surface antigens may be the cause of infertility here. Next, obstruction of the efferent ducts. The efferent ducts may be obstructed by infections like tubercular, gonococcal, or by surgical trauma, which is herniorrhaphy following vasectomy. And also failure to deposit sperm high in vagina, which is a coital problem, which is for erectile dysfunction, ejaculatory defect, which is premature ejaculation, retrograde ejaculation, or absence of ejaculation. It is difficult to deposit sperm high in vagina. Erectile dysfunction, ejaculatory dysfunction, hypospadiasis also, which is a congenital condition in males in which the opening of the urethra is on the underside of the penis. Next, coming to errors in the seminal fluid. Low fructose content, usually high or low volume of ejaculation. Errors in the seminal fluid. Seminal fluid also equally acts in cases to conceive in the infertility in males, which is low fructose content may lead to infertility, usually high or low volume of ejaculation, high prostaglandin content, and also undue viscosity. Coming to the causes of female infertility here. In females, there is ovulatory dysfunction, tubal disorders, uterine factors, cervical factors, pelvic endometriosis. First, coming to ovulatory dysfunction or ovulatory factors here. That is anovulation or oligoovulation. There is absence of ovulations. There is ovulation every menstruation time. There is one egg release in a female. So that condition, if there is no ovulation of this hormone of the egg here, then it will lead to absence of egg, which is an ovulation here. Decreased ovarian reserve, luteal phase defect, and luteinized unruptured follicle will contribute to ovulatory factors. tubal defects, common infections to the tubules, which is fimbriase, septal infections, peritoneal factors, and also altered tubal motility. There is a defect in the movement of the tubes. Okay, pelvic adhesions, tubal obstructions due to some cancers or due to something occupation, there is something like obstruction in the tubes, and also distortion of normal tube and ovarian relationship, impaired pickup of oocyte by the fimbriae, that is impaired pickup of egg by the fimbriae. Other causes will be dyspareunia, which is a poor coition function or a painful or dryness of the vagina, abnormal peritoneal fluid, abnormal systemic immune response, increased sperm phagocytes by macrophages, fertilization and implantation failure, early miscarriage. So these are the other cause of the female's infertility. Firstly, there is dryness of vagina, also there is painful coition, and also poor coital function here contributes equally in females in infertility cases. Abnormal peritoneal fluid and also abnormal systemic immune response, increased sperm phagocytes by the macrophages. There is fertilization and implantation failure on the endometrium, and due to the explained in the hormone abnormality and also luteal phase defect, henceforth the embryo will be unable to come and implant over the endometrium of the uterus. There is also early miscarriage and or abortion, hence there is very difficulty in conceiving. These are the factors of the females in causing infertility in females, and in the further next video I will be explaining about the investigations and what is the treatment given in allopathy as well as homeopathy, what are the procedures. We will be seeing it in the next video, and if you have felt this video helpful, so kindly do like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon and stay tuned to get notified on all of my videos. Thank you.